everyone. Mike Skahan here, senior pastor of Epic Life Church in Terrell, Texas. And this is our 3-Minute Thursday, where we take 3 minutes or less and look at subjects and topics of the Bible. Today, 3 minutes on the tithe. Should new believers, New Testament believers, follow the tithe? And let me tell you, before we get to really the tithe portion, I want to show you a scripture in Matthew chapter 6, really from a verse 19 down to a verse 24, that's very, very powerful, and I believe important to the topic of tithe. In verse 21, Jesus responds to his people and he tells them, "For where your treasure is, there also will be your heart." The tithe really shows and really highlights where our heart is, what you are investing in. I tell people all the time that if you want to know what is important to you, look at your calendar and look at your checkbook, because those two things will tell you what you spend most of your time in. And that's really what the tithe does. The tithe shows us where our heart really is. It's not really a matter of whether or not we should or shouldn't tithe. Most believers, matter of fact, all believers know that they are supposed to tithe, but it's the idea of thinking, should I tithe or why should I tithe? And really it's about the treasure of our heart. Now here's what I want you to notice in Matthew. From Matthew chapter 6, verse 19, all the way down through verse 25, you're gonna see something that's very interesting. In between all of that, in between gathering treasures on this earth and then worshiping manna, which is symbolic of money or currency, in between those things, there's a Hebrew idiom that I want to point out to you. And it's found in verse 22. Would you read this with me? Matthew 6, 22 says, "The eye is the lamp of the body. Therefore, if your eye would be healthy, your whole body will be light. But if your eye would be evil, your whole body will be in darkness. Therefore, if the light which is in you is dark, how great must that darkness be?" Now, many people don't understand that this is a Hebrew idiom, and they actually think this is about good and evil, when it actually is not. The Hebrews would know that this was about generosity. If you had an eye filled with light, it meant that you were a very generous person. And if you were filled with darkness, it meant that you were a very selfish person. See, the tithe helps keep that in check in our hearts. It allows us first and foremost to focus back on God, back on the things of the kingdom, because that's where we're investing in, and becomes and helps us become generous. If you're a selfish person, the greatest weapon for you is to become generous. It's the only thing that can counteract selfishness. And so in my last few minutes, I want to say that the tithe in the Bible in Malachi chapter 3, verses 8 through 10, you can read this on your own. It tells us to bring the tithe, and that when we bring the tithe, what God does is he opens up the windows of heaven and pours out a blessing that we cannot contain. You see, the tithe is the access point for you and I's life, for God's blessing over our finances, over our life. And so if you're questioning about tithe, or maybe you're struggling with the tithe, here's what I would like you to do. Begin to just pray about it. And maybe you need to start tithing, and maybe you're not there at the tithe yet, but maybe you should start just trying to be generous where you are in your finances, in your time, and in your gifting. Begin to tithe that, and then work up to a full tithe, which tithe means a tenth. Giving God a tenth of all your increase, and God will bless you beyond your measure. That's what the Bible says, all right? This has been our 3-Minute Thursday. Keep pressing into the presence of God. God bless you, and we'll see you again.